Hey guys, John of Rockin' TV1.
How you doing?
So today, I thought I would show you this here Craftsman vise that I picked up. It's a 3-inch angle vise, 24083, and this was very cheap. It was like under 40 bucks, and if you're in a Craftsman club and you save up your little Craftsman dollars there, I think I only paid like 10 bucks for this thing. Turned out great. But let me show you why I grabbed this vise. Number one, it actually is a quality piece. And wow, yeah, where's the front? While it's more than likely, made overseas, it really doesn't matter to me because I'm going to show you the rest of these vices and how you can pick up a cheap vise for your mini lathe or for your mini milling machine, which a lot of guys have these days. A lot of guys can't afford a Bridgeport, and I certainly can't afford a $600 Kurt vise. Even though I would love to have one, I can't afford one. And even if I was to go ahead and take what may or may not be questionable quality, Glacern or Shaw's or any of those other vices, I can't speak to their quality. And by the time I ship it over here to New England, I'm still at halfway to a Kurt vise. Let me show you this. Okay, comes with all your little wrenches, nice little plastic bag, and this is an angle vise. And about a month ago or so, I made a gib strip for my Logan lathe, and I didn't have a way to hold that angle, so I had to file it by hand, and I got guys thumbing my video down. I guess that's the only thing, you know, at least I can make the pots, and I can make them myself, and I can make them right. Way better than this thing. Some of you guys may have saw my cross-slide angle milling attachment video from last year, and this is one of those, you guys can probably recognize this piece here. And this thing is really a POS, okay? There's a shaft in here. I'll show you a couple of differences about vices. There's a shaft in here that locates this jaw, and these are really probably technically drill press vices. But this thing's got more slop in it than you can shake a stick at. Not to mention the ways. The casting is all just, you know, to me it's a casting. And now that I have a milling machine, having a milling attachment on my lathe is not a priority anymore. But I'm going to make the video and make the pots just for you guys so you can get to see it. I did buy a 626 Harbor Freight milling machine, the mini milling, the knee mill, the 40939. And I had this 3/8 angle plate laying around, and I milled that off. And when I use like 6 or 7 different straight edges on it, which are not NASA perfect, but when you, excuse me, when you compare 3 or 5 of these together, and you come out with 1/1000 of an inch and some feeler gauges and your, you know, dial indicators, excuse me, then you can come up with a pretty close number. And guess what? I'm absolutely certain that I could bolt that on top of my mini lathe or my Logan lathe and come out within 1,000. And while that's, again, not NASA perfect, 1,000 is pretty dang close, okay? So depending on what you're doing, that's certainly better than chucking something up on my drill press with this thing here. Miles better, okay? So let me show you. This is a yard sale vise right here, and it'll be easier for me to show you on this. I picked this vise up at a yard sale for $5, along with this Columbia vise, okay? That was, I think I gave the guy $3 for that one there, and I had to rip his bench apart to get that off of there because I didn't have any tools, but they were demi in the house. So this is a Columbia vise made in the USA, and it's perfect. The jaws line up perfect. What else can I say, okay? This, I cannot speak to who made this or where it was made, but the slide, okay, this thing fits perfect. There is no slop in that at all. The ways are perfect, okay? Now you guys, you can put this on. What I use is either on the table of my milling machine, or I have some very heavy granite tile, Italian tile and marble tile left over. And again, they're not NASA perfect, but they're within 1,000. And you could do a setup like this, or you can use a surface gauge and run across your ways and find out where you're at. And if you have a milling machine, then you can fix some of this stuff. This vise right here is within 1,000. Within 1,000, okay? That's a $5 yard sale vise. But way better quality, the same sort of construction as this, but way better quality. I don't know who made it and why, but here is a Lowe's vise, okay? This is certainly a drill press vise. It's this Lowe's vise is nowhere near the quality of this Craftsman or even this yard sale vise or even that yard sale vise. It's got this scrap strip in the back here and no locating dowel. It looks to me like there's almost enough room to put one in there, and so maybe I'll do that down the road at some point. But this is a $20 vise from Lowe's. You might recognize that name. The screw is looks like it was a casting, just like this one here, and you know, chrome plated, and it's kind of crusty. But if you're doing drill press work, that's about all this is good for. That, or you know, maybe anchoring your canoe to the side or something. This Craftsman vise, however, is a quality piece. The screw is, I don't know if that's black anodized or what's up with that, but the jaw is rock solid in there, rock solid on its, on that shaft. And it does this angle thing. You have this pin, you can put this in a bunch of preset angles that they have on here, and if you don't want to use those angles, there is this jack screw and the locking screw on this side over here. And I got this because I can then go ahead and set angles on pots in my milling machine or wherever this vise ends up on my Logan lathe, because it's a little big for the little big dog there. But a quality piece. For anybody that has drill press work, if you're doing woodworking or whatever, I would definitely recommend this vise if you can go down there and pick one of these up. Definitely pull it out of the box and make sure you don't get one that somebody dropped or it's missing a hunk out of the casting. They only had a couple of these there, and I grabbed this one, and I am very happy that I did. So for under $40, and if you're in the Craftsman Club, this is a smoking deal, a smoking deal. It's kind of hard to get a piece of metal that heavy with that kind of quality for that kind of money anymore. So, hey, thanks for watching, you guys. John Rocket TV's one said that.